Hello and welcome to the Django DRF project, eCommerce. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials which you can watch for free. The link to the YouTube course playlist is in the video description. This course is also available on Udemy, where you can watch the course ad-free, download the tutorial source code, and access all updated tutorials and playlist. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Now that we have developed a few different components of our application, let's now start further developing our testing environment. So as a new developer, it can be difficult to understand or to identify what exactly needs to be tested. Now, in this tutorial, we're going to learn how to set up coverage so that we can automatically learn or auto-discover some of the tests that we may need to create. Now, this isn't going to show us potentially all the tests that we might need to build. A lot of that will depend on what it is that we feel we want to test and how far we want to move into testing. There are different types of tests to add to the mix as well. So let's just set up coverage, or let's explore how to utilize coverage here in Pytest to explore what tests might be needed. Now, don't forget, you will find a document here, commands, and I have named it appropriate to the section that we're currently working in. So you will find all the commands there. They might not be very well structured, but you will find the command there or thereabouts, and that can be downloaded where you'll find the source code. Right, so let's just close up some of these modules. Right, let's get rid of that. Let's just minimize that. Right, so let's go ahead and just close that server, kill that, refresh that, and clear that. Right, so let's try Pytest. So we have already created in the previous tutorial one test, and that's in the test folder here, the sample test. So we can go ahead, just get rid of that. We don't need that anymore, right? So let's just remove that. Now we can use coverage through or integrated within Pytest, or we can install it separately. And I've decided we're just going to install it separately. So let's go ahead and pip install coverage. Right, so let's make sure we pip freeze and update the requirements. Okay, so now we can run coverage, and this is going to provide us some additional information. Well, it's going to provide us information in regards to where tests might be required. So now we need to run coverage. So let's go and give this a go. So coverage and then run. And now we need to specify Pytest. Let's give that a go. Okay. So with that done, you can see that we have this coverage file here. Looks like that's happened. So what we can now do is run coverage HTML. And that's going to then generate this HTML page here. Now, this is just one way of working. So this is going to provide, or it's going to produce this HTML cov folder here. So what we need to do is just make sure that in our git ignore, that we are ignoring all these. We don't want to save this to our source control at all. So it doesn't look like, it looks like HTML cov still being added. So let's go ahead and just add that to our list here. So we don't want to save that. And in addition, we don't want to include .coverage. So we've already added that in our git ignore. Okay, so I think we're up to date with that. So let's now navigate into this HTML coverage here folder. We need to open up this file here, index.html. So now we need to open up this file. So let's go into our browser and open it up. So here in Safari, at least we can just go to File and then Open File, for example. It's just one way of doing it, of course. We know it's going to be in our documents, right? GitHub, and then DRF and Commerce. And then inside of here, and you can see in HTML cov, and it's right there. So let's open this up, and you can see that we've provided a report. Now, we can output this report in the command prompt. I chose not to show you that just yet. But what we've got here then is, let me just zoom in. What we've got here is a report that's been generated by coverage. And you can see that we have five different columns here, statements, missing, excluded, and coverage. So if we move down to models here, you can see that there are 21 statements within this models file. and there are three missing tests. So coverage is identified potentially where three tests are required within the model's file. And you can see if we move down, it has a total of three. So that's what it's found. Those are the tests that have been identified as needed. Now, it seems a little bit strange because we also have some code in the views, which probably also need to be tested. And this is what I was alluding to, the fact that this will provide us some information, but it won't cover all types of tests. So we will need to infer some tests that we're going to need to build. So let's do these first when we get to that point. But I just wanted to show you the fact that you can move in to this file here and it identifies what might need to be tested. So here you can see in the models that we're going to need to test the done the string method to ensure that the data is being returned correctly, because we've specified that when we output, or the default output done the string method should be the name. So when we output a record here, that object can be referenced by its name. And that's a customization that we've made. So we need to make sure and test for that. I will try and be careful here when I say you have to test for that. You don't have to test for that. You don't have to do any testing at all, of course. But it's just a recommendation from the software that we try to test as much as possible. And in general, when we're testing, we do want to try and test as much as possible. But there is, of course, a balance here. Now, what we need to remember in this application is that it is very loose. The brief is very loose and we are making lots of changes. And in this type of situation, we can end up writing more tests code than actual project code, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. But when you consider how loose the project is in this case, and lots of things might change, we might end up having to change the test every time we make a small change. And that's just going to add additional overhead to the project. So my intention here is to try and guide you through some of the tests that are going to be required, not necessarily build too much, but as we start to zone into certain areas and to tidy up and refactor code, and maybe later on in the project, potentially at that point, we'll start to get a little bit deeper into testing when we know that things aren't going to change as much. Now, I did mention that there are some other tools. We didn't necessarily have to install coverage, so let me just quickly show you those. So let's go ahead and pip install Pytest. And this is one of the benefits, again, of using Pytest. There's lots of different packages to kind of extend functionality. So we're going to install Pytest coverage. Now, I don't know if I updated the document previously. Bear with me a second. If you remember the commands document here, doesn't look like it did. So let's just add coverage as well to my list. So what we can do here, we need to add the command in a second. What we need to do here is install Pytest coverage. Let's just add it to our, maybe I've got it. Yeah, to our requirements. And let me just update that coverage command, which we used earlier. So the opposite of this, or the alternative to this now that we have Pytest cov installed, what we can now do, if I just clear all this, instead of running this command here, I can now run Pytest and then dash dash cov. And that's going to give me some similar information. You can see it's running in the terminal here, but we still have access to the different types of reporting. So we've seen the HTML kind of reporting option. So you can see here that we are provided with similar outcomes, in that we need to test three, or there are three tests potentially missing here in the models. So you can see that's an alternative way of working.